Wally, the games just keep coming. Is this moment at the moment, is it a good time to be rotating the squad? You obviously got a rest last night, but how do you feel about the schedule of games? There's one every 3 days at the moment.
I mean, as a football player, you love to play a lot of game, of course. So, yeah, the also important is also to have a big squad with a lot of quality players. That's what we have also. And as you see the last game, the coach changed a few players to give also the chance to the other players. So, yeah, that's also good for the other players because we have a lot of quality in the team. So it's also nice to have an other teams in the games.
How would you rate the way the team's playing at the moment?
Our team?
Yeah.
We're playing quite good, actually. We're playing good as a team. The mentally is also good in the team. And yeah, I hope we can just continue like that, how we're doing it in the Europa League and also in the competition. And the last game was also important for us to win this game to go to the half final. So yeah, we just have to continue like that.
The start to the league season has been particularly good. It wasn't that long ago that we were talking about the defence being a bit shaky, and obviously I think that result against Cluj a few weeks ago, the manager thought there was an overreaction to that. Did you in the dressing room feel that there was also an overreaction to it? Because since then you've been pretty much perfect.
Yeah, I mean, it wasn't that easy in the beginning, of course, but I think we kept the focus. We kept the focus, and the confidence was for sure there. Even it wasn't easy in the beginning of the season for us, for me also especially. But as I say, I just kept to work hard, and the adaptation also was important for me. And now you can see also on the pitch as a team individually that we're doing very good. So yeah.
How long did it take you to adapt? Because you got a bit of criticism at the start of the season when you first started playing, didn't you?
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. How did you feel about that?
I mean, I don't see about criticism, and I only focus on my football. I know my qualities, so yeah, I just knew by myself that I needed a little bit of time. But yeah, I'm happy now that I can help the team also with my qualities, and hopefully I can just become better and better player in the Celtic.
Do you feel that you have established yourself as the number one left back? Do you think you're the man in that position now?
I'm just working hard, doing my best to be the number one, of course, and I'll always be open. If the coach put me as number one or number two, I'll always work hard for the team to accomplish the goals.
Because obviously Greg Taylor got signed on deadline day, and Johnny played there last night. So
yes, of course, as you see, also Johnny does very good also. When he plays on the left back, also Greg Taylor is a good young player, talented player also as left back. So yeah, we have a lot of good players in every position. So the coach have a lot of choices to do, and he can always count on every player whenever he want.
Neil Lennon, has he spoke to you about the situation with the left back? Because you arrive at the club and then another left back arrives and one leaves. Did you ask for any clarity as to your position at the club?
No, I came here, you know, I came here, I signed here to Celtic to play, and yeah, even if I were they bought another left back for me, it's always good to have a positive, healthy concurrent, you know. So for me, it was always, yeah, I didn't even thought about this, that it would make something in my mind, so you know, I just stayed focused, and yeah, we work hard together also, me and Craig, also Johnny Hayes, we help each other to make each other better, so.
Do you feel more comfortable playing in that position now for Celtic than maybe when you started the club?
Sorry?
Do you feel more comfortable playing in that position maybe than did you when you arrived at the club?
Yeah, of course. In the beginning, when you arrive in a new club, it's always like I'm a little bit seeing to find your place, of course. But as you see, I'm enjoying now every game, and it's always amazing to play in Paradise. So yeah, I feel more comfortable now. Yeah.
It's not just left back, obviously, across the whole defensive line, central defenders, right backs, even midfield. I mean, how has the team been so good at quickly establishing that kind of defensive solidity, even though you have so many new defenders?
Yeah, I think for the new players, it was just you needed to be quick in the mind, you know, to adapt that in the team. And I think we did quite well, like Hatem and Christopher Gillian, we did all good. Even Maurice, the last debut, he did very good. So it's good to have players like this that can adapt fast in a new team. So yeah, you can see defensively, we become only better and better. Also offensive, we have a lot of qualities, of course. And yeah, we can just do it, continue like that.
Do you think it maybe is an advantage for you and the other new players that it's almost a clean slate, it's everyone's arriving for the first time rather than maybe you being the only new player? Is it easier for you in that case that there are so many new players who are also settling in?
It doesn't matter. As long as you have the quality, as you when you are a good player, it doesn't matter if there you have like five new players or only one. When you have the qualities, you can adapt in every situation. So I think, as you see, it didn't take so long for the players to adapt. So yeah, we can just do our best, continue work hard every game, and hopefully we can reach our goals.
You say you've settled at Celtic now. Do you think you have improved as a player since you've signed?
Yes, for sure, for sure. Since I've signed here, as I say, that the adaptation is also like you need to, the quality, of course. When you arrive here, you have a lot of quality players. So I think for myself, I proved already. But I'm improving every day. You know, every training, I'm working out, improving, and yeah, like I say, I want to become a better player, a bigger player here in Celtic. So yeah.
And how much of that improvement is down to the management, down to Neil Lennon?
I think we're still improving, you know, we're still improving. To Lennon, I'm just proving him every game that I want to be the number one, of course. And every player want to prove the coach, of course, that he wants to play. On the training, you see that everybody is motivated, so yeah.
Wait, sorry, when you were with Rapid Volley, obviously you reached the knockout stages of Europa League, which is obviously what Celtic are trying to achieve this season. Do you think that this Celtic team is better than the team that you play with? Rapid, do you think that they can go a long way in Europe? You know, is it feasible?
I mean, Rapid, I have had also a good team, of course, but Celtic, as you see, we have a lot of quality players, so it depends all on us, you know. It depends all on us. You cannot say that Rapid is better or not, or Celtic is better. It depends all of the team, how good we're going to do it in the Europa League campaign. So, yeah. I can just tell that we have a good squad, and I believe that we can do something in Europa League. So yeah.
Is it possible to get to the late stages? Do you think, is this squad good enough? If you can get through the group,
if we continue to work like this and to become even better defensively and offensively, then yeah, I'm positive that we can for sure do something in Europa League. Yes.
You think you can go far in Europa League? You're unbeaten domestically as well. How long do you think you can keep that run going?
As long as we can, of course, yeah. But we just focus on our game by game. Now, Saturday, we have another game. Focus on that, and that's where hopefully we can get 3 points again back to home. And then we have an important game also on Thursday. So we just focus on game by game, and hopefully we can keep it like that to be unbeaten.
What have you enjoyed most about Scottish football so far?
About Scottish football? Yeah. Paradise, to play at home.
Yeah?
Yeah. That's always the first.
Any specific games or...?
Specific games, I can say that, okay, maybe I didn't play, but I enjoyed just the atmosphere against Cluj at home. It was amazing, even I didn't play, but it was a nice experience for me on the bench, but I really enjoying to play for the Celtic fans, really. It's amazing.
Bally, the manager said he was very pleased with your link-up play with James Forrest when he played on the left with you. How easy is it? For you to adjust to all the sort of changes in front of you around the team?
We have a lot of players, good quality players in front, so yeah, you need to adapt in every player. You know, every player is different. That plays in front of me, like Mike and Johnson, and now for James Forrest also. You have also Mohamed, and so a lot of players can play in front. So yeah, I just need to adapt on them, and they have to also to adapt on my quality. So we just need to understand each other to bring something. So offensively and defensively, of course.
The game last night, there was quite a lot of players that got a game that have been waiting for a while. What's the mood been like in around the training? Has it given a bit of a lift with players getting game time?
I think we are one team, so even the players that played yesterday they're also important for us. It was important that we won this game yesterday. And the coach changed a lot of players because he believed in them. He believed in the whole squad, so that's important also to give opportunities to other players also to get their chances to show their coaches.